Alrighty, everybody, it is time. The video that you guys have all been waiting for, my $1,000 Whatnot Funko Pop package, has arrived. So, let's get started. And now, if you guys don't know what I'm talking about in terms of my Whatnot auction video, I definitely recommend checking it out. So I will have it linked in the description down below if you guys want to watch for yourself. But now, guys, let's cut into this package because I am so excited to see if the figures came in okay and also what do they look like, because I've never seen these ones in person for the most part. All right, everybody, here we go. And also, I do want to mention that Savage Pops, you shipped this over perfectly. Like, I see no dents or dings on the side of this box. Like, seriously, thank you so much. All right, everyone, so we are inside the package. Now, let's see what these look like. And also, I do see some paper on the top. So nice packaging so far. More paper. More paper. Ooh, hold on. Before there's more paper, there's actually a pin. And it is the Savage Pops pin. And if you guys don't know, this is who I bought all of these figures from. It was his auction. So seriously, thank you guys so much for having such a great auction. All right, everyone, I had to flip this thing over, but here we go. This is the figures right here inside of this giant paper box. Paper box? It's paper, whatever. All right, everybody, now after all of that paper, there was actually bubble wrap inside of here. Now I have to unravel this, and I'm gonna try to show you guys these figures one at a time because it'll be a little bit easier that way. And now, guys, while we're doing this, I'm going to tell you exactly how much I purchased these for during the auction. And I guess we'll start with one of the cheaper ones, which is the FYE exclusive Monster Stitch. Now, this is one that I had never seen in person because apparently it did come to Sunrise Records here in Canada, but it just never came to mine, or maybe I just completely missed it. And if you guys are wondering, I've got it here. I bought this one for $25, so honestly, not that bad. And now I did notice that all of these were shipped in hard stacks, so it does seem like they came in pretty much the exact condition that I saw them during the auction, which is perfect. And now, guys, also on the back of the box, this is to go with the new wave. So we have Lilo with Scrump, Stitch with Ukulele, the Stitch Sitting, the 10-inch Stitch Sitting, as well as the Lilo with Pudge. So I'm definitely glad that I could grab this one to help complete this set. And guys, looking at this figure a little bit closer up, I really do enjoy how it looks like he's stomping on a bridge, which I believe is the Golden Gate Bridge. It's hard to tell because he has already stomped on it in the figure, but then he also has the two cars in his hands, one red and one blue. So anyways, guys, that was Stitch, but now let's get on to the next figure that I got, which would be Turret from Portal 2. Now, this one is definitely an interesting figure and honestly doesn't even really look like a pop. The only thing that I would say is a defining feature that would kind of make it like a pop is the red eye in the middle. And if you guys are wondering how much I paid for this figure here, Turret, I got for $22. So honestly, not bad because this one came out in 2017 and you don't really see this one in stores anymore. Oh, now this is interesting and also something I've never seen in a pop before, but Funko, like, seriously creative for doing this. You guys can see on one side it shows Turret, but then the opposite, Portal, and it's got Shell poking through. Now that is neat. And yeah, guys, overall, this is just a really weird and well-done figure, and I want to get more of these ones in the future. Definitely Atlas and Peabody, and then maybe Shell. Like, I want to get the whole set. I just don't know how I'm going to get them for a reasonable price. Like, this one was definitely decent, but the other two, they're going to be a little bit tougher. And now, guys, after Turret, let's get on to the next figure here, which I'm going to go with the Diamond Collection Only at Target Energizer Bunny. Now, this one is definitely a sparkly one. Like, you can really see the glitter on this figure. And if you guys are wondering how much I paid for this figure, I paid $43, which is a little bit pricey for a figure that you could probably still find in stores in some places, but we don't have Target in Canada, so it was definitely worth it for me. And if you guys are wondering, on the backside here, there isn't any other figures like the common one. It just literally has the Energizer battery, and then it says still going. And I really do enjoy this, and I love when Funko does this on the figures. I don't think they did it for any of those ones, but you guys can see where they normally have the number in the corner. This one is actually the Energizer Bunny's drum. Like, very, very creative. I don't know why I said very twice, but it's definitely something that Funko doesn't have to do, and when they do add stuff like that, I really like seeing it. Oh, now this is interesting. I thought it was gonna be just the fur parts that were Diamond Edition, but if you look closely, you can actually see that pretty much everything is besides the sunglasses. Neat. All right, guys, now we are halfway through the stuff that I got in my auction, but now let's get on to the next figure here, which is going to be Cutie Corn. And this one here is a Funko Hollywood exclusive, and I've never seen this figure in person before, so it's definitely neat to see it today. And if you guys are wondering on Cutie Corn, I paid $93 for this one. So far the most expensive one that I've shown off today. We are getting more and more expensive as we go on. I think you guys can tell, but this is a neat one, and I'm so glad that I could get it for under $100 because I feel like they go for a little bit more than that. And I mean, I haven't checked in a while, but if you do factor in that you have to go to the Funko Hollywood store to get this figure, I'm okay with paying $93 because that is much cheaper than a flight to Hollywood. And also, this is really neat because this is one of the Fantastic Plastic winners. And if you look on the backside here, it actually tells you all about Jacob Martindale, who is actually Mr. Collected over on Instagram. I definitely recommend checking out his stuff because he really does make some great art. And there's a little bit about him right there. Actually, one more thing before we move on to the next figures, I did want to mention that I love that it looks like he's dressed up for Halloween, and it totally makes sense because Cutie Corn dressed up for Halloween as a skeleton, it really is neat. And he also has that little pump pumpkin basket in his hand, and then a chocolate bar on the other. Like, really, some amazing details. All right, everybody, now we are getting into the big figures here. There's two of them, and both of them were over $100. And this next one that we're gonna be talking about here is the Funko 2019 Box of Fun 500-piece exclusive Freddy Funko Surfs Up Batman. Like, this is a crazy, crazy cool figure. And now, if you did watch the auction video, I talked about why I got this figure, but I also wanna pull it out for today's video. It's because I have the Surfs Up the Joker, so now I've got the entire set. And if you guys wanna check it out, here is the Freddy Funko Surfs Up the Joker. Like, definitely a really neat pop. And both of these were, this one was limited to 3,000 pieces, where this one was limited to 5,000. I guess it makes sense because this one is Batman, but if you guys wanna check out both of them together, there they are right there. Like, this is seriously a neat set. And now, looking at both of these next to each other, I really, really enjoy both of them. And again, seriously, like, this was just one of those things that I never thought I would get for my collection, because you had to buy them in the Box of Fun from 2019. And that was the thing where you just got like three random figures. So to get both of these, it's pretty crazy. Oh, and I don't remember if I mentioned how much I paid for this one. It was $200. I mean, kind of pricey, but definitely worth it to finish off my set. And the good news was the set was only two characters and there wasn't a Robin out there somewhere. So it does make it a little bit easier, but definitely still need to have both. And now, guys, let's get on to the last figure for today, which is actually something that I paid a lot less for than I thought I was going to be. And this one here is the original, the first ever Pop Televisions, The Simpsons, Homer Simpson. Oh, this thing's sick. And now, when buying this figure, I knew that the box wasn't going to be perfect, but I mean, seriously, it looks really great for a figure from 2011. Like, that was a year after they started making Funko Pops. Oh, and also, in case you guys are wondering how much I paid for this one, it was $377, so pretty cheap compared to what they normally go for on eBay. And now, because this one's so expensive and I've never seen this Homer Simpson in person before, I definitely want to take this figure out of its protector just so we can see it a little bit closer up. This is probably not good, but I mean, I gotta get it out of here somehow. Come on! Come on! Come on! I think it's stuck. No, wait, hold on. Hold on, I think I just have the edges here. You guys are gonna hate me for this. I gotta do it though. I gotta pull it. Come on, come on. There we go. Okay, I think I can get it a little bit more. There we go. Whew, kind of nervous. But anyways, guys, here is the Homer Simpson right here. Like, there is a little bit of like sticker residue on the front, maybe even from it being on sale, which is crazy to me. And then on the back side here, there was this. And they did mention that during the auction, but I didn't really care because once you throw it in a protector, you're never gonna see it. Everybody, now I think we know what the next step is. We have to take Homer out of the box because I really wanna see this thing up close. So let me see if I can just pop this thing open. Ooh, that was really easy. Okay, here we go, guys. This is my first ever look at the original Homer Simpson from 2011. But anyways, guys, here is the original Homer right here. And also, I tried to turn the head and it doesn't seem like it wants to. Ooh, I'm gonna be careful with this thing, probably because it hasn't been touched in so long. But here is the Homer right here. Like, seriously, this is a crazy cool figure. And also, I didn't show off the back of the box, so if you guys wanna check it out, here is the original set of Simpsons Funko Pops. We've got Homer, of course, because that's one that I bought, but we also have Marge Simpson, Bart Simpson, and then Krusty the Clown, and they never remade these characters like this ever again. So it is really crazy to have a figure like this in the collection. Even though it isn't in perfect condition, I did get it a little bit cheaper than what it normally goes for, so I'm totally okay with how it looks. But seriously, I love having original Funko Pops like this in my collection. And so even though this thing isn't in perfect condition, I did pay a little bit less for it, so I don't really care. But yeah, I just love having older figures in my collection like this Homer Simpson. Now guys, this one I definitely have to be careful with. So Homer, back in the stack you go. And well guys, there you go. This is all of the figures that I got in my latest Whatnot auction. And if you guys want to go check out the video, again, go to the link in the description down below, because I do also bid on some other stuff that I wasn't able to get, so it would be cool to go back and check out the other stuff that I missed out on. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more from me in the future, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, do all that. But this has been another episode of Top Pops. Popsters, thanks for watching. See you guys tomorrow. Whoa, I'm a big bag hunter with the bow. She got a big bed, number drop low. Mama called me and she happy with the grow. Never ever fall for a party that's a no. Just bought the Kenny, I bought a million options. So just talking to stop doing the gleaming. I rock arenas, bringing the peace. I'm bumping that park in the car, pretending I got all the eyes on me. Got a bad baby and she's independent.